A recent call by one Israeli lawmaker to deploy a doomsday weapon against Hamas and Palestine in the ongoing war has put the limelight on nuclear weapons in the region, namely the Jericho missile system. This week, an Israeli lawmaker called for her nation's military to use nuclear warfare in response to attacks by Hamas. Revital Tali Gottlieb, a member of the Knesset for Israel Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's Likud party, posted multiple posts on X advocating for a forceful retaliation following a surprise attack by Hamas. The call for the use of the Jericho missile system comes as more than 2,200 combined Israelis and Palestinians have been killed in the ongoing war against Hamas. What is the Jericho ballistic missile program? Gottlieb specifically mentioned Jericho in reference to Israel's initial ballistic missile program developed in the 1960s and named for the biblical city. While the program was formed with French aerospace company Dassault, France withdrew in 1969 and Israel maintained the system and had the solid fuel Jericho 1 model ready in 1973 during the Yom Kippur War. The Jericho 1, which was retired in the 1990s, had a weight of 6.5 tons, a length of 13.4 meters, and a diameter of 0.8 meters, according to the International Institute for Strategic Studies. It had a range of 500 kilometers and could carry a 1,000 kilogram payload, though it had a 50% chance of hitting within a 1,000 meter radius of its target. Israel later developed the Jericho 2, a longer-range missile in the late 1980s with a length of 15 meters and a diameter of 1.35 meters while maintaining the same payload capacity. It had a range between 1500 and 3500 kilometers. The Jericho 3, an intermediate-range system, was introduced years later and was reportedly tested in 2008, entering into service in 2011. It featured improvements over the previous models with a longer length than the Jericho 2 and a larger diameter of 1.56 meters. It is not yet clear if Jericho 3 has been deployed by Israel during the ongoing retaliatory offensive against Hamas in Gaza. Meanwhile, Israel formed an emergency unity government on Wednesday as it pounded Gaza to root out Hamas and deployed forces north of the densely populated Palestinian enclave where the militants said they were still fighting after their cross-border assault. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu agreed to form a war cabinet with former defense minister and centrist opposition party leader Benny Gantz and focus entirely on the conflict, a joint statement from Gantz's National Unity Party said.